You can see thousands of them breeding when the warm season starts. And they only lay one egg at a time. And if you take one away, they lay another egg, but no more. But I want to tell this story really about one incident, one day. It was a gray, misty day with the wind blowing hard. And there was a heavy swell running. And the whale factory was pitching and yawing. Not really a very good day to pick up the whales over the stern of the factory ship. There were one or two dead whales at the stern of the vessel. And the whale catchers were coming in with their whales. And in the distance you could see the icebergs. Quite a number of them. And the men were trying to get ready to pull the whales over the stern of the vessel. There was a pack of killer whales around, which came tearing towards the factory ship. Chunks out of the whales. And there were a number of men at the stern of the vessel with guns shooting at the killer whales. The minute they hit the killer whale, the rest of the pack went after him and tore him to pieces. But let's get back to the story of the penguin. As there were about six or seven whales, some of them blue, some of them fin, at the stern of the vessel. And there was that small rock penguin sitting on top of the whaleback. And as we were pulling up the whales one after another over the stern of the vessel, which was rather difficult with the heavy swell running, penguin hop from one whale to another. The killer whales were all around the dead whales. They were tearing into them and the sea was red with blood. And by that time, there was a number of men from the whale factory coming astern and watching the penguin at the back of the whale. And the men were shooting as fast as they could to stop the killer whale from getting the penguin, which was sitting or trying to hold on to the back of the whale. But as the whale was pulled up the chute, it was difficult for the winchman to regulate, and he had to watch very carefully not to, with the swell of the vessel, with the swell of the sea running and the vessel moving, to stop the penguin from slipping off its back. The chute was quite steep. It was about, I would say, 30 degrees, and the little penguin climbed close to the tail of the whale, from which the whale was pulled up the chute. And the men were all standing around and watching and hoping that penguin finally could get up on deck. wheel up. There was a swell the winchman up on top had to watch and be as careful as possible not to jerk and increase the movement so that the little penguin could stay up on top. We got him to the stern of the chute. At the beginning of the chute, and we got the we kept on slowly pulling, and as we pulled, the little penguin slowly but surely went along the back of the wheel from the tail to the middle of the back. But at that time the sea was running heavy and the movement at the stern was rather erratic. Finally, when we got him up about 3/4 of the way, I don't think there was a man working on the stern of the factory. They were all watching and hoping too that the little penguin would get up on top, as the killer whales were just waiting down below and just watching. And the men were shooting and trying to kill these killer whales, therefore they were afraid that the little penguin might slip in the water. Finally, when we got it really all the way up, everybody started to breathe a sigh of relief. But there was a heavy, heavy swell which came under the factory and rolled the wheel on the side, and the little penguin slipped off. And as it went down the chute, the killer whales got it. Most of the men were not happy that day. Therefore, also there's millions of penguins. That was one of the sights which they did not care to see again. But that's the way in the Antarctic. There's no give and take. It's a hard, hard place to be in. But c'est la vie.